Certainly want to welcome all of our guests who are here. I certainly want to welcome the children and the parents from Tramway School. It's really good to see you here. We have some guests I'd like to introduce. Margaret Murchison, it's always good to have you here. Emily Grimes with our military children. Thank you for being here, Emily. Charlie Parks, chairman of the county commissioners in the back. And Will Doran from the Sanford Herald. Welcome here and thank you for your attendance. At this point, will you please join me in a moment of silence as we reflect on the day's activity. Thank you, and now please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag. We will now proceed with the public comment portion of our meeting. To our speakers, I'd like to remind you that that the board may fairly and adequately discharge its overall responsibility, citizens of Lee County desiring to address the board shall be given the opportunity to sign up the day of meeting in order to be placed on the board agenda. The chairperson will allow 3 minutes per person, not to exceed 30 minutes. To ensure an orderly presentation and disposition of items, board members will not respond to individuals who address the board except to request clarification of points made by the presenter. And Dr. Bryan will keep our 3 minute time limit. Our first speaker is Sandra Bowen. School. It's a low income
Thank you.
Our next speaker is Mr. Keith Clark.
Showed essentially no gain in property values over the coming. And as a result, in order to fulfill promises to maintain a revenue neutral rate and provide tax cuts, the commissioners found it necessary not to remove, continue $500,000 to your board, and had to take the money from Sanford. My idea is that if we have a concept school of some kind that from across the county, the $14.5 million that's now being considered would be better, a portion of that would be better addressed to working with the county and with the school board to encourage them to come downtown. And that could take the form of assisting in land acquisition, preparation of the site, and certainly landscaping of the site afterwards. I don't want to complicate this issue, because I think it's one that ought to be addressed separately, but there is also, in my mind, another way to bring traffic to downtown would be to move the county library there, make it a learning center, and then people would be coming down. With this being a K-5 school, parents would be picking up frequently and dropping off their children. There'd be PTA meetings, class plays, parent-teacher conferences, and things that would surely bring people down, as opposed to other projects which are being discussed, which we have to take on faith or some premise that somebody else has done it in order. This would bring people downtown. The restoration of downtown would be in the interest of the board, because it would help build property values that would make it possible for the school board to have additional funds students. And I'll leave that with you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Clark. I would now like to share with the audience our vision of where our schools are headed. This is from our strategic plan. Lee County Schools, in partnership with the community, will provide challenging learning experience for students in a safe and supportive environment. We are committed to academic excellence, social responsibility, and lifelong learning. Our success will be demonstrated by the achievement of our students and their positive participation in society. And I'd now like to share with the audience a code of ethics under which board members serve. We as board members must avoid conflicts of interest and appearance of conflicts of interest as we handle the work of the board. We must avoid the solicitation and or acceptance of gifts in return for advice or assistance on matters concerning the operation of the business at hand. We must avoid misuse of public funds. We must avoid misrepresentation or falsification of facts. And we must avoid making confidential information public. Prior to approving the agenda, I would like to entertain a motion for an amendment to the agenda on advice of the attorney, school board attorney. It has been recommended that we remove item number 2 from new business. Is there a motion to make this amended agenda?
I make a motion that we amend the agenda.
Second.
It has been moved and seconded. And Mrs. Brogan, would you like, on behalf of the ad hoc committee, address these concerns?
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chairman. The ad hoc committee, we have met and we have had interviews, but we are not prepared to make our recommendations at this time because of pending litigation involving the Board of Trustees.
Is there any further discussion on this issue?
I just for understanding, the suit that was filed prevents us from acting in filling these appointments. Is that correct?
That's correct. On July the 30th, there was a restraining order entered by a Superior Court judge in Lee County Superior Court that enjoined all parties from taking any action of any kind to remove or otherwise interfere with the plaintiff's services as CCC trustees prior to the expiration of their 4-year terms. And this was in the lawsuit filed by the 4 trustees appointed by this board. So it's my position, and I so advise the chairman, that we are enjoined from taking any kind of action until something happens in the lawsuit.
Is there any further discussion? Hearing none, all in, please vote in favor of amending the agenda. Please say by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? The amenda is agended, so I will entertain a motion to approve the agenda as amended.
I make a motion that we approve the agenda as amended.
Second.
It has been moved and seconded. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? The agenda is approved. I would now entertain a motion to approve the minutes from June 24th, 2013, July 9th, 2013, July 22nd, 2013, July 29th, 2013, and July 31st, 2013.
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion that we approve the minutes that you just read for tonight.
Is there a second?
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor approving the minutes, please signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? The minutes are approved. At this point, I'd like to recognize Dr. Bryan to introduce our students from Tramway School.
I'll ask our principal, Ann Beal, to come forward, please. I understand we are in for a world of entertainment tonight.
About 5 years
on this field that I wanted to beat drums. And could I please have a class where we did nothing but beat drums? we start the class by talking about the day and the week and how we've done our test and how homework's going. They know if they see me in the hall, I'm going to ask, you know, what's going on in the classroom. The classroom teachers know to come to me if we need a little motivation. This group I've been lucky enough to work with since they were third grade, and this is their fifth grader. So they're like, my drum family. I've got logo middle school this year. But we want to show you three of our policies, procedures that we do. But it's not a performing group, and I brought extra instruments. It's a participation group. Would y'all come play with us, please? Would you please come play with us? I promise it's not complicated. Finish the beat. I play three beats, then you guys are going to play beat four. For example, we'll show them. Okay, guys? One, two, three. All you have to do is play number four. Whatever I do, you play number four. Here we go. Thank you. circle can give is to let someone cut the group off. You ready? Finish the beat. I play three, you play four. One, two, three.
I think this confirms the fact that at least the Lee County Board of Education has got rhythm. We got rhythm, folks. Thanks again to Mrs. Beal and Mrs. Spivey for bringing your children for us this evening. This was a great, great performance. Under Chairman's report, I do have a couple of things I'd like to bring to the attention of the board. Mr. Akinosho, Dr. Bryan, and I have had some meetings recently, and one topic that came to our attention was the potential for a board retreat. It's been some years since we've had a board retreat, and we thought it was time to have another. We thought that the month of October would be a proper time to do it, as all of the stats from DPI will be available at that time, and that certainly will be a part of our meeting. Some dates that have been suggested are October 11th and 12th and October 18th and 19th. They are just suggested dates. Look at your calendars and get in touch with Mrs. Britt or Dr. Bryan or I, and let's see if one of those two weekends would work for a retreat for us in October. And I'd also like to remind the board that the lawsuit concerning the four trustees appointed by this board and previous boards of education will be heard on Thursday, October the 15th at 2 p.m. in Lee County Superior Court, courtroom to number two. And I'd certainly encourage anyone who can to attend this court hearing on behalf of this board. And now we can proceed with the superintendent's report.
Thank you, Doc.
Excuse me.
Did you mean August?
Yes.
What'd I say?
October.
August, yes, August. It's next Thursday. Thank you.
2 days.
I'm 2 months ahead. Dr. Bryan.
Thank you, Dr. Smith. At this time, I'd like to ask Tammy McGill in her finance office to please come forward. I know a lot of people already know this, but in Lee County, we're very fortunate to have an outstanding finance department. But our finance department, and I'm going to turn over to Ms. McGill in just a second, our finance department sort of backs up sort of the talk in reference to how proud we are of them and their job. Just for your information for the public, since 1989, the State Board of Education has recognized finance officers for outstanding financial achievements. And there are three very specific awards that the State Board awards every year. First one is the Government Finance Officers Association Certificate of Achievement, Excellence in Financial Reporting. This is a GFOA established Certificate of Achievement for Excellence in Financial Reporting in 1945 to encourage and assist state and local governments to go beyond the minimum requirements of generally accepted accounting principles, to prepare comprehensive annual financial reports that evidence the spirit of transparency and full disclosure, and then to recognize individual governments that succeed in achieving that goal. Ms. McGill and her finance office have won that award for this year, but that's not all. A second award is given, the Association of School Business Officials Certificate of Excellence in Financial Reporting. This is a national award given annually to finance officers who have voluntarily submitted their school system's comprehensive annual financial report, the CAFR, as sometimes it's called, for review. The ASBO panel review presents this award to those CAFRs which meet or exceed ASBO standards. A district earning the Certificate of Excellence receives not only the award, but enhanced credibility for the financial management of its school system. So that's two awards. But why stop at two when you can have three? State Board of Education Recognition of Achievement Financial Resource Management. This award is presented annually to finance officers of units who have shown effective cash management and use of state funds, accurate and timely financial reporting, and no salary audit exceptions or position overdrafts as of fiscal year end. To further that, it's also recognized for areas of excellence in these particular parts of the award. Salary audit exceptions or position overdrafts, state or federal position allotments, state dollar allotments, cash zero out, invalid expenditure codes, and UERS data compliance. Needless to say, our finance office has won these awards this year. To make it even better, they are one of only 10 school districts in the state to win all three awards. And just to top that off, for the 16th year in a row. Mm-hmm. Given the current budget situation and times we live in, I am so happy to have Ms. McGill and her staff here in Lee County Schools. Ms. McGill, could you introduce your staff? Second part of our agenda, the Lee County Home Builders Association has a recognition to make tonight for Teacher of the Year. I'll ask our Director of Career and Technical Education, Mr. Aaron Fleming, to come forward to help present that award.
Been around these too many years.
Absolutely.
Wes Hawkins is the current president of the Secondary Home Builders Association. The state level always picks a Teacher of the Year, and for the last number of years, we've never chosen anybody from Lee County, and we presented to him this year to be the our representative of the Secondary Home Builders for his hard work, dedication. I've worked with him and Aaron for several years now through the grant that we got through Golden League. And Grant Steele comes out, he's brought kids out to the meetings that we have. And our field right now is struggling. There's not a lot of homes being built in Lee County. Some of the other places maybe, but not here. And we just wanted to recognize Grant tonight for all the hard work he's done.
Thank you so much for everything you do for Lee County Schools. This time I'd like to ask Ms. Glenda Jones to come forward, our Assistant Superintendent for Human Resources, to introduce this year's cohort of the Sand Hills Leadership Academy.
All right, at this time I do want to recognize our three
to have three ladies, and I want to recognize them along with their principals where they're based for this school year. The first one, I know we have some trouble here hearing, Crystal Colwell, and she is based at Lee County High School. Yes, Lee County High School.
Thank you, Ms. Jones. This time I'd like to ask Dr. Jim Atkinson to come forward. While he's making his way up here, I'd just like to add my own thoughts. He's going to recognize our former SRO officers who have been with us. I'd like to ask them to come forward, please.
But we do appreciate them, and we had some officers that could not make it tonight, but we do appreciate what they've done over the course of the year, and we wish them nothing but the best in the future. Again, we miss your dedication and professionalism that you've shown us at this kind of school throughout your community. So I'd like to present you with these plaques of appreciation.
Thank you, Darla.
Thank you guys for kind of giving me my start in on this side of law enforcement. You know, I'd had some previous detention, but thank you for giving me my start on this side. So I'm still going to be with you guys. I look forward to continuing working with you with the Sheriff's Office and I enjoy working with you guys, and, you know, so we'll still get it done. Looking forward to it, all right?
Thank you. This time I'd like to provide a budget update for obviously 13-14. The significant budget cuts that we're facing as a school district, obviously from the local, state, and federal levels, have been well documented. Although this reduction in funding for public education has potential long-range consequences for our children, the key question that we face today as a school district is how do we deal with it? After numerous conversations with individual board members and input from countless meetings with community members, it is very clear to me that there is a strong consensus to protect classrooms in Lee County schools. Protecting classrooms means keeping teachers and teacher assistants. As a board, you have outlined the school district's highest priorities in the current strategic plan. In your recent budget resolution in support of North Carolina's children and educators, you clearly state your support for the classroom and the reasons why that is important. You point out quality teachers and staff provided with continuing educational opportunities are the key to effective student learning, and effective and efficient support systems are necessary to support student and employee success. Our highest priority is to enhance our children's individual growth opportunities and to ultimately support the future well-being of our community with educated citizens. To meet these goals at the classroom level, we are forced to make the following reductions and restructuring of services. One, reallocate state funding used for other purposes to guarantee the same number of teachers and teacher assistants as last year. Unfortunately, this will severely reduce funding for things such as supplies, materials, tutors, and staff development opportunities. But given the current circumstances, it is the best option available. Two, restructure our media centers at secondary level by eliminating 4 media specialist positions and replacing them with media assistants. We will also reduce the total number of media assistant positions from 8 to 6. Attrition and retirements will account for this restructuring. Three, delay a laptop refresh for the 2013-14 school year and use those funds for teachers and teacher assistants in the classroom. Four, freeze the current position of Associate Superintendent for Curriculum and Instruction. The Director of Academic Services position will no longer exist. Five, eliminate the graduation and bachelor's program and reduce the amount of funding available for tutors because of local cuts. Even though this budget requires difficult choices, we still have an obligation to remain innovative as a school district. We live in an interconnected global economy driven by technology. That is a fact. Your strategic plan and budget resolution support innovation and technology as two of our highest priorities in order to ensure the economic betterment of students and the community. As a board, you have insisted upon fiscal responsibility and accountability in providing these learning experiences. For that reason, I am forming an internal superintendent's advisory committee of school district employees led by Cindy Johnson, our chief technology officer, to reevaluate how we are using our technology, software, and related programs. I will specifically ask this committee to evaluate a bring-your-own-device program and cheaper alternatives to the current digital devices used in schools as we plan for the 2014-15 school year. I will also ask this committee to reevaluate how we deliver instructional services and content to students from a digital platform. My goal for this committee is to explore innovative and more cost-efficient ideas to prepare our students for a successful life beyond high school. The committee will have approximately 45 days to complete their work. The deadline will coincide with the budget reconciliation and a board retreat in October. Given these budget cuts, I am reassured by 2 very important things. First, that the commitment of our educators across Lee County schools. From numerous conversations and interactions, they are committed now more than ever, to doing the very best job possible in the classroom, despite the negative message they have been sent by the state budget. As I have said before, I would expect nothing less from our dedicated professionals in Lee County. Second, I am encouraged by the many positive comments you as a board have received from Lee County educators, educators from across North Carolina school districts, and community members regarding the budget resolution that you passed at our last meeting. The North Carolina Superintendents Association even sent it to every school district in the state. The outpouring of positive comments for your resolution has been very encouraging. These comments reflect a common theme I've heard regarding how reassuring it is to see an elected body take a stand to support our children, our educators, and public education. Mr. Chairman, those are my comments on the budget.
Thank you, Dr. Bryan. We'll now proceed with committee reports.
I've still have a couple other things. A couple other things. At this time, I'd like to ask Mr. Dietrich to come forward. Mr. Dietrich is going to give us a brief update on our power school transition. He will explain that in relation to power school and home base and how that fits into the big scheme of things.
Well, as report card templates, we have a report card template right now, either from the
If I may add one thing, felt like it was important to bring in a little bit of outside help with the scheduling piece, because we were concerned, as we have been for several months going back into the spring, we just wanted to make sure everything was ready as we got the school year going. And I felt like that was really important. So that was a decision that I made in reference to making sure our folks are trained.
I have a question. With school starting in just a couple weeks, do you feel that you'll be close to being ready by that point? I know you're waiting for those components from the state. Do you have any idea when you'll be getting those?
I do not have an exact timeline, but I can tell you they will be here on August 23rd. Mm-hmm. If I could, I'd be thrilled at helping them backwards down the aisle.
They just don't.
What does that do to you, Rob?
So you cannot, excuse me, you cannot use a Power School and NCWISE concurrently until everything is settled.
No, that is correct. We have very few in the county have access to NCWISE just in the event to check data. But that as a whole, NCWISE is gone, and Power School is the new student information system.
Okay.
So I assume that you're optimistic that by when time school's starting, you'll be well on your way.
That students will have schedules.
Okay, very good.
Classes will start at 8 o'clock,
okay.
And the kids will show up, and we'll be able to help.
We're ready to go. Okay, very good.
Unless you've ever had to depend on the Department of Public Instruction, you can't give a timeline. So yeah, they're doing exactly what is necessary for the children, and I applaud your efforts.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. I think I start some meetings with the words today.
Absolutely.
So what I do is I stand before you today with what I have right mm-hmm. now. That could change by the time I go home and eat dinner.
Mm-hmm.
But that'll be small.
If I may, Rob has committed overwhelming amounts of time to make this happen. Going back to last year. So I think it's important that you know that. This is not an 8 to 5, 9 to 5 kind of deal with things. I mean, he's committed a lot of time to this. So thank you, Rob.
Thank you, Dr. Thomas. But I would be remiss if I didn't include my people. I have great office staff.
Absolutely.
And I have an incredible office staff.
Absolutely.
And I have a very patient, for all of you out there, I have very patient people in the county who are also working with us. They understand what we're doing and what we're going through. So I applaud everyone that is involved in the process to help us get it right. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Very good.
Thank you, Rob. This has been pretty well documented over the last week, but I just want to take note, just congratulations, again, sort of what Rob said, just congratulations to the whole system for our graduation rate. And we went from 84 to 86.4%, 2.4 increase. Just really nice, nice gains, and certainly that's our entire staff, pre-K through 12, is to be commended, because that's their number. This is not a, some people look at it this way, but this is not a high school number. This is a system number. and we have a lot to be proud of. So I just wanted to mention that again tonight. I know it was sort of documented in the paper last week in the media, but certainly outstanding work by a lot of good people. Final thing I'll end up with is just for you an update on the superintendent transition plan. We have started meet and greet sessions in the community, and we started that last week at Broadway Elementary School. And last night we were at Deep River, and we've had, between the two sessions, we've had about 100 people come out, and they've had great questions and comments and have been very enthusiastic, and I have learned a great deal about where I believe this community wants to go. And I think it will be great for us as we begin our conversations in October and even before then about looking forward and involving the community in this discussion, in this decision. And I'd just like to thank everybody who's come out, and I really appreciate the ideas. And once we get the meetings going, people feel free to share their thoughts, and I really appreciate that and encourage that. We will be at Ingram Elementary School on Thursday night, 5:30, and hope to see everybody out. Now I'm finished, Dr. Smith.
I mean to cut you short.
No, you're fine. That was my fault.
Let's do proceed with committee reports. We'll start with curriculum instruction. Linda Smith.
Mr. Chairman and the Board of Education, there was a call meeting of the middle school and high school C&I, and that took place on July the 31st at San Lee Middle School. And the purpose of this meeting was to discuss the MOA for the day treatment program at Bragg Street Academy, and recommending also at that meeting and recommending approval of the Science Innovation Lab course to be offered at San Lee Middle School this year. And this is going to be a pilot program. And I believe at that meeting there will be a progress report coming out between 30 to 45 days about what is going on in that program. And so we'll get that information. You will find on the consent agenda tonight the MOA and the recommendation for the Science Innovation Lab. And hopefully, unless you have some questions about that, the two of them.
Thank you, Dr. Smith. Facilities and technology, Mr. Bernardi.
Mr. Chairman, facilities and technology has not met since our last meeting. Our next scheduled meeting is August 27th.
Finance, Mr. Akinosho.
I just want to say that we've not had a formal meeting, but like you have seen, the finance staff, that they've been working very hard, and I've been talking to the superintendent a lot about how we move things around to keep our teachers and staff, which is our important asset here. I was out of state last week, and I have somebody from Huntsville, Alabama schools who were telling me that they were looking at a lot of great things that we're doing in Lee County. And I said, wow, okay, that's wonderful. And one thing I want to say to you is that if you're not proud of what we're doing in our school system, maybe you are not looking real inside of what our staff are doing, our teachers are doing. Our greatest asset is our staff and teachers who are doing wonderful work. So with the budget, thanking every staff for what they're doing in the finance and the new superintendent for being sensitive to the need of our school system instead of just having his own agenda. Thank you, Andy.
Thank you.
Policy, Mr. Sharp.
Mr. Chairman, we hadn't met since our last meeting, and our next scheduled meeting is August 20th, 1 week from today.
And lastly, I would like to recognize Mrs. Brogan to report on her many hours spent in the state legislature.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Chairman. My legislative report for tonight, and I'm covering three bills. I'm going to try to roll through it. A lot of information. The day after our last board meeting on Wednesday, July 10th, I went up and spoke at the Senate Education Higher Education Committee for House Bill 512, which is the one with the Board of Trustees for Community College. When I got there, I found out that the night before that there were some changes made to the bill. And so basically the changes were explained to me by Mr. Dan Sussek, Senator Sussek. He pulled me aside and let me know what was going on. The changes would, our four trustee appointments would be split between us, the Board of Education of Harnett and Chatham County, and we would all have to share the four. And then also the four Board of Trustees appointments that we have that are now part of the lawsuit, they would be cut off. I believe it was August 1st or 13th. They would be cut off, and they wouldn't be allowed to be reinstated onto that board, just those four. Of course, I wasn't happy about that. I thought that was not a very good way of doing things. I couldn't understand why we weren't allowing those four to finish out their terms before the changes were made. That was just common sense to me. But I was glad that if the four appointments that we, you know, sharing with Harnett and Chatham County, I was glad to keep it in the realm of education. That was very important to me. And that's what I spoke about to the committee, that, you know, I felt that we needed to keep it with the boards of education and not with the commissioners, because we're dealing with education. We have such a tight relationship with community college. We have a lot of programs, and I told them about Lee Early College and the Caterpillar program, and, you know, I'm sure there's many that will in the future that will be working with the community college. So I felt that it was very important that we keep it in the realm of education. So I did get to speak against the bill. Commissioner Parks and Walmack from Lee County spoke in favor of the bill. It was about a 45-minute discussion. It was the only bill on the agenda, and it went on for a good while, and there was many good questions from the senators during that 45 minutes, a lot of it pertaining to why those four particular people were getting kicked off. There was a lot of questions pertaining to that in the committee that day. And of course, Mr. Stone and Senator Rabin were in favor of the bill. So there were a lot of good questions raised, and they were concerned about that. But it still passed committee that day. The following day, it went to the Senate floor on July 11th and passed. And then the changes that were ratified by the House on July 15th, and then it became law. And as you know, we have the lawsuit that's now pending. The next bill I want to talk about is the one I went up the following day on July 11th for Senate Bill 236, which was the school construction bill. And I want to give you a little history background on this bill, because it changed a lot. It started out as a statewide bill that was going to affect the whole state. Then that was changed to just include about 10 counties, and Lee County was one of the counties in the 10 counties. That bill was co-sponsored by Senator Rabin, who is our local senator. When I went up that day, I was one of many school boards there. I represented Lee County, but there was school board members from Harnett County, Wake County, Guilford County, and there was a lot of commissioners there as well from different counties. I spoke against the bill to the House Government Committee, it was in their agenda that day. And once again, Commissioner Parks and Walmack from Lee County spoke in favor of the bill. And I have to say that my remarks were quite passionate in opposition to this bill. And also to give you some history, basically what the bill would do would give our school buildings control over to the commissioners, which of course I'm not in favor of that. I feel that we need to be in charge of our own buildings. And I really was passionate to them about how I felt that it's part of the education process, that our buildings are part of the process, and it just makes common sense for us to be in charge of our buildings. And so I had a good comments. There was many people that spoke that day. I believe there's about 12 people that spoke, and it did fail committee. So it did not make it out of the government committee. It failed. I heard later that evening it went to the House floor and was debated for about 30 minutes and was decided to put it into the rules and operations of the House committee, which was where it came from before the government committee. So this is where it gets kind of interesting. So it failed, and it goes back into the rules, and it's sitting in the Rules Committee. So With crossover, there's a certain time limit where you have a limit where you can introduce bills if you want to get it heard by the end of the session. And crossover is when a bill has to go from one part to the other, from the Senate to the House or the House to the Senate. But at that point in the legislative session on July 11th, it's too late to introduce any new bills. So what happened is they took Senate Bill 236, which had, you know, was sitting in the House Rules Committee and came from the Senate, and they stripped the language out of it and used it for a totally different bill. So if you look up 236 on the website, it will talk about Superior Court judge perform marriages. So it has nothing to do about school construction anymore. But also, House Bill 726 was developed, and they did the same thing with this bill. House Bill 726 was a bill that passed the House. They took the language from it, changed it to something different, and they put it into just Wake County. So it was a bill that was a local to Wake County for school construction, because remember, it failed with the 10 counties, and that was just down to Wake County. Well, that, it did not pass the House. It failed on July 24th with a 54-62 vote. So it was close, but it did not pass the House. So it did not affect Wake County. So my third bill I want to talk about is House Bill 491, which is the SRO bill, which is a local bill affecting Lee County. On July 24th, Dr. Smith, Dr. Atkinson, Dr. Bryan, Darla, and myself went to speak at the Senate Rules Committee in opposition to this bill. We got there and it was a bit crowded because there was many bills on the agenda, and they moved our bill to the front of the line. And despite, and this is very upsetting to me, and it was to all of us that day, but despite the secretary of the chairman knowing that we were there, we informed them that we were there and we wanted to speak on this matter, Senator Apodaca did not allow us the courtesy to speak, which is very, I feel very unprofessional in our legislature for that to happen, especially on the local bill, to deny local leaders the opportunity to speak on a bill that will affect us profoundly. On a local level, I thought that was very tasteless. But we were not given the opportunity to speak. Senator Rabin was in favor of the bill, and Representative Stone also were in favor of the bill. It went very fast. It was about very fast process. A few minutes, it was done. And the debate just lasted for a few minutes. There was some concern raised by Senator Nesbitt and Senator Stein, but that was really the only discussion. It went by very fast. It was a close vote, but it was a voice vote, and the yeas had it, and the bill passed the committee, which it moved on to the House and ended up passing with a 72-40 vote in the House on July 24th. So it went very fast. We were up there on the 24th, it hit the House and passed just hours later, 72-40. After that experience, we did have a conversation with Senator Raymond and Commissioner Womack, who was there. And it was a very interesting and exciting conversation. So that was our experience on July 24th. And like I said, I thought that was just the whole way that was handled that day, I thought was very unprofessional and very tasteless for that to happen in a committee meeting. I think that we should have been given the respect to at least make a few comments since it pertained to us. So I was very disappointed that we drove all that way, all of us were together, and we were not given the common courtesy to speak. I thought that was not very well at all, very, very tasteless. Oh, and I just want to add one more thing, my notes here. Representative Stone did not talk with us after the fact. He was not available. Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, I have a few comments and some questions concerning what Ms. Brogan has to share with us. It seems apparent to me, and maybe it's just me, that most of the legislation, proposed legislation, and some that eventually has passed, that is put forth by Representative Stone and Senator Rabin, specifically target education. it's disappointing to me that it seems that Mr. Stone and even some of the leadership of our local county commissioners would use local legislation like this to try to strike back at those who oppose them politically. I think it's a disgrace. I think it's shameful. And the people of Lee County deserve better. And hopefully we'll get better. The questions I have, and maybe Mr. Love can answer these questions, pertaining to the legislation that passed, that's now law, that required us to dismiss our SO officers, and now they are part of the Sheriff's Department. Am I correct, Mr. Love, that law also denies us the ability to contract with any agency to provide, even like I know in the past we have had security guards for the parking lot here at Lee Senior and at Southern Lee, but that law denies us the ability to hire an agency to provide those security guards. Is that correct?
The way I read it, it decertified our SRO organization and stated that they could not be recertified, and also stated that we couldn't hire outside enforcement. I believe that's the way I read it, yes.
So I'm correct in that we couldn't hire an outside security agency to provide a security guard for the parking lots as we have in the past.
I'd have to read it, but I think just from my recollection of the bill, that's true.
Actually, Mr. Bernardi, I was able to pull it up while you were speaking. The part that was ratified, the Lee County Board of Education is decertified as a company police agency under this chapter and shall not be recertified. The Lee County Board of Education shall not employ or contract with a company police agency certified under this chapter.
So basically what that says to me is that as a board, as a Lee County Schools, we have no options or no alternatives other than the Lee County Sheriff's Department to provide for the security at our schools. And that's a concern for me in the fact that although currently our current sheriff is you know, a former SRO chief, and I'm confident in his ability to and his willingness to work with us in ensuring that we have officers, you know, that will stay at the schools they're assigned to and not be called out for other duties. But, you know, that's an elective office. He's not always going to be sheriff. And
if you will read that again, please, Ms. Brogan, the last part. I think what it says that we can't hire any agency that's certified under that SRO law. There's a law.
I understand that. But what I'm getting at is if it comes to a point that we're not satisfied with the level of service, say down the road, Sheriff Carter is no longer sheriff and someone else is there, and they decide that, well, you know, we don't need an officer full time at this school, we'll split the time. And I'll put another officer out on patrol. We've got no options. And my question is, what can we do? Is it possible to have this law overturned? I mean, could we file suit and possibly get the law overturned?
Well, I doubt that litigation would help you too much here. I think the legislature created this body, and the legislature created the SRO, the statute, where you have SRO officers certified, and I think they could decertify it, but it seems to me that it was appointed direction that you couldn't that we decertified us as an SRO. We have a, see, we have a an agreement, and we've been certified, this Lee County Board of Education has been certified as an SRO qualified agency.
Right.
But with this legislation, we are decertified and can't be recertified.
I understand that, and I guess my point is, before we were ever certified, we had options. We could have contracted out with any agency to provide those SRO. I mean, we could have contracted out with the police department or.
Well, I think you could, yeah.
But we don't have those options now.
No, I think you could have a contract with, say, just for the sake of argument, the Sanford Police Department to police your the grounds. You know, I think you could, because they're not certified under that SRO legislation. But they couldn't provide SROs. Correct.
Right. Well, and the reason I ask about the possibility of filing suit is obviously, you know, we've been talking about the suit that's been filed concerning the laws concerning the trustee appointments. And certainly, to me, this law is the very definition of arbitrary and capricious. And, you know, and not only that, to me, it interferes with our statutory responsibilities in providing, you know, ensuring that the Board of Education will provide a safe environment for our children and our staff. And, you know, I mean, unless you just think there's that it can't be done.
Well, I would be glad to look into it and give you my opinion or take a little work, but if you ask me right now, I'd say that you probably could not get be successful in overturning this statute.
Right.
Or this local bill.
So we would just have to overturn the legislature.
Well, yeah.
and pass a new law. Yeah.
You just have to get somebody to repeal this.
Right, locally, yes. Which, from what I understand, that's not too hard for a local bill.
Thank you.
Thank you for your comments, Mr. Bernardi, and thank you for all the many hours you spent in the legislature, Mrs. Brogan.
Oh, you're welcome. It was quite a learning experience. This was a very interesting session.
Back to the agenda. There is no unfinished business, so we'll proceed with new business at this point.
Consent.
Oh, yeah. We do need to do that. Is there a motion to approve the consent agenda as presented?
So moved that we approve the consent agenda.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded to approve the consent agenda. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor of the consent agenda, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? The consent agenda is approved. And now we can proceed with new business. And the first item on this new business is recognition of the Education Foundation by the North Carolina School Board Association 2013 Business and Nonprofit Honor Roll. And I'd like to read a piece of this. The North Carolina School Boards Association has issued a call for nominations to the North Carolina School Board Association Business and Nonprofit Honor Roll. The Honor Roll is a way for school districts to recognize those companies and individuals that support the education of our students, especially as schools face increasing budget uncertainty. School districts must adopt a resolution of nomination and submit the nomination by the North Carolina School Board by August 16, 2013. Do I hear a motion to approve this honor roll?
I make a motion that we approve the Education Foundation for the honor roll.
And is there a second?
Second.
And before we start the discussion, let me read the resolutions that's required to do this. Whereas public schools and local businesses and organizations are an integral part of this community, and whereas many local businesses and nonprofits play a crucial role in supporting our schools, and whereas the economic health of our community, state, and nation depends on a strong public school system, and whereas collaboration between local public schools, local businesses, and nonprofits strengthens schools and the community alike by providing a well-trained and highly educated workforce, and whereas an excellent public school system is vital to the quality of life in this community and fundamental to preserving a strong democratic society now and in the future, Therefore, be it resolved by the Lee County Board of Education, names the Lee County Education Foundation to the North Carolina School Board Association 2013 Business and Nonprofit Honor Roll, showing appreciation for the organization's ongoing support of our public school. The Lee County Education Foundation work has aided this community in focusing on the goal of providing the best educational experience possible for every job. And I think it's very appropriate that we nominate the Educational Foundation to this honor roll and recognize what they have done for our community. Is there any further discussion?
I just want to further what your comments. I think that this is great for us to honor them in this honor roll. I know that the Education Foundation, as you said, Chairman, has done a lot for our school system over the last 10 years that they've been an organization, and I'm just very happy to work with them and excited to work with them, and they're just a great organization, and I'm so pleased and happy that we have a great relationship with them and for everything that they do for Lee County schools and our children.
Any further comments? Hearing none, all in favor of approving this resolution, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Like sign. The resolution is approved, and we will forward this to the North Carolina School Board Association. The next item is salary schedules, and the chair will entertain a motion to approve the salary schedules as presented.
I make a motion that we approve the salary schedules as presented.
Second.
The motion has been made and seconded. Is there any discussion on the salary schedules?
I just think it's important that as the community understand that our salary schedules are just that, that's the base salaries. And so even our teachers are offered a supplement, while it's not necessarily what other districts are able to offer their teachers, and that there are also supplements for our central services employees as well. So when community members see salary schedules, I want them to understand that that's not just the budget that we have for salaries. There are other things that incentives that we try to offer employees to ensure that we show their appreciation.
Thank you, Ms. Carlisle. Any further comments? Hearing none, all in favor of approving the salary schedules as presented, please signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? The salary schedules are approved. And finally, is there a motion to approve the Lee County High School Carpentry Project House bid?
I move we accept the bid of $50,000 from Tommy Smith for the Lee County High School Carpentry Project House.
And is there a second?
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. Is any discussion on this motion?
I actually have a question for Mr. Fleming about the house project. It sold for $50,000. This is a Lee County house, correct? And I was wondering how we came out with that in the budget, money-wise, how much it would cost to put into it.
In the history of the house, this is the first year in which we'll have lost money in it. We have roughly $58,000 in supplies and materials in the house. After three attempts to sell the house in our final auction, we did secure $50,000 in the sale. Or excuse me, actually, we have $47,000 in the sale of the house. Attorney Love allowed us to open up an upset bid period where we did get the $50,000.
Mm-hmm.
This has been a rough year for the house. I think for the Lee County house, we had around $58,000, or excuse me, Southern Lee House, we had around $58,000 in it with a sale of $60,000. And working with our carpentry teachers, this coming school year, we're going to build one house here at Lee County High School. Southern Lee students will be transported over to work on that house. I believe we somewhat flooded our own market. Buying a house at auction is not typical. It's not customary for folks to do that. I think sometimes they get nervous of what they're getting into. So hopefully by just doing one a year, we're able to get some local folks that want a quality-built house by students and be able to at least gain our investment back.
I'm glad that this program will continue, because I think it's a great program. I'm a big, you know, proponent of career technical education, and I think that it's great for their students to learn those skills and have that opportunity. So I'm glad that, you know, we will continue on despite, you know, how things turned out with that we did lose some money on that house, but it is a great program for our students, and I'm glad that we're going to keep doing it.
And it's also a learning experience for our children. So the purpose of it is not just making a profit, but teaching the children, because I see a lot of times we send kids to California for competition, we pay for it. Mm-hmm. So we don't make any profit out of it. So if we're giving them an opportunity to have a hands-on, to learn something, it's not all about profit. We've made profit over the years, so it's okay for us to teach them how to build. Amen.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Thank you. And I certainly would like to thank you, for Mr. Fleming, for being proactive in these tight budget years to make sure we don't have another budget deficit next year. That is the end of new business. Mr. Akinosho, if you'll make a motion.
We need a vote. We didn't vote.
On the last one.
All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? It's sold. Now, Mr. Akinosho, if you'll make a motion.
I move that the Lee County Board of Education go into closed session for the purpose of discussing information that is privileged, confidential, or not a public record under NCGS Section 143.318.11 at A and B, A and 1.
Is there a second? It's been moved and seconded. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
We will adjourn to closed session, please. The chair will entertain a motion to approve the human resources report as presented.
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion that we approve the human resources report as presented this evening.
Is there a second?
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. Is there any discussion on the human resources report? Hearing none, all in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
And is there a motion for adjournment?
Make a motion that we adjourn.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
We stand adjourned.